Hi, I'm Donna Jordan from Jordan Fabrics. Today I'm going to show you how to make a really fun quilt called One Fish, Two Fish. And we're going to use beautiful bright batiks. We have a strip set here already cut. And this will be our ocean background. So I'm going to lay the strips out on here and we'll pick out which ones we're going to use and then we're going to get started sewing. The first step is to pick out all the strips for the fish. The fish are made in bright colors, and we want all those colors to stand out from our ocean-colored background here. Now, I'm gonna make the twin size. It's kind of a big twin, and I'm gonna need 26 colorful strips. So I'm gonna just lay these out on here until I get 26 that I like. There's 40 in the strip set, but some of them are really dark blue. Even this one, which is light blue, doesn't show up very well against the background. So we will put that one aside and we'll just keep picking the ones that are going to show against the background. I might use purple, but you know, it's not enough contrast. So I'm gonna set that guy aside. And I will just keep going and pick the 26 that look the best on the ocean. Here's the strips I've picked out to make the fish out of. All of these colors are bright and cheerful and they have a large amount of contrast between their colors and the background color. So the next step is going to be make strip units, four strips at a time for the body of the fish and then some two strip units for their fin. I have all of my strips placed into units. So this is going to be one set of four strips. I'm going to sew them side by side and that's going to make some fish bodies. Then we've got another set here, all these different sets, and I put them so that the fabrics would look nice next to each other. Then we've got a couple of two strip units. This is going to be two, 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 and those are going to be for the tails. So the procedure's the same on all of them. So we'll just take these two and we're going to sew them side by side. And you want to use a fairly small stitch length because we're going to be cutting these after they're sewn together. So anytime I'm going to sew and cut afterwards, I'm going to use a real small stitch length. So put the fabrics carefully on top of themselves and don't stretch either one. Now I'm going to finger press the seam to one side. So I'm going to open this up and kind of hold it open with the palm of my hands. And I like to draw my fingernail down it, but if you don't have strong fingernails, just the tip of your finger, just the pad of your finger, really opens it enough until you get it to the ironing board. And then we will really press it flat. All of the strip units are sewn together. Here's all of the four strip units. And here's all of the two strip units. So I've already finger pressed everything to one side, but we still want to steam press it with the iron. So I'm going to lay it flat on my ironing board here, and I'm going to put a yardstick up next to it to make sure that I've got it nice and straight. And then I'm going to press it flat, first with no steam, and then again with some steam. And then I'm going to do the same thing with all of the four strip units. Now we're ready to cut the four strip unit into the bodies of the fish. The Cozy Quilt Designs has all the sizes that you need in here, and I used that to make this triangle shape out of this plastic template. So I like to set the template on here and hold it in place, and then I'm going to take my plastic ruler and I'm going to slide it up right next to this plastic template here, and it'll stop when it hits it. Then hold this in place and move this guy. That way I can cut with my right hand right along the edge here. Now the easiest way to make the next cut is to flip the whole thing around. Now I can continue to cut along the right side. So I'm going to put the template right along the edge of the fabric and lining it up with that cut we already made. Hold it in place. Then again, put your straight edge right along that plastic, slide that out of the way, and make your cut. So that's the body we need. Now we're going to move the template to the other side, and we can't go right up to the edge because it's got that hook in it there. So we're going to move it down here, and we're going to make this cut first, and then we'll clean that side up. We have all the fish bodies cut here. That's the ones we just did. There's all the other strip units cut up. So we have a nice variety of colors there. The next step is to work with the fins. So these are the strip sets that have two strips. Now, the pattern calls for a lot of colored strips, and then it says you need 16 2.5-inch strips out of your background or ocean color. If you have the strips already cut up into 2.5 inches, then you're going to need to sew some back together. If you don't have them already cut, you can just cut a 4.5-inch strip, and then you will not have to do that extra seam. So you can do it either way. The pattern says to take your 2.5-inch strips and sew two together, but I hadn't cut mine yet. So I'm just gonna take a 4.5-inch strip. It's cut exactly the same as this, and we are going to stitch these right sides together on both sides, and we're gonna make a little tube. Here is the fin unit. We've got the two colorful strips, and we've got the ocean color on the back, and it's a tube now. So we're just going to leave it flat like this, and we're going to iron it just a little bit to make sure our stitching seam is relaxed, and then we're going to cut some triangles out of here. To cut the fins, I've drawn a smaller triangle here, and we're putting that line right on the cut edge of the fabric. And again, I'm going to put my straight edge ruler up against the template, hold it in place, move the template, and then I'm going to make the cut there. Now we'll turn it around, put the template back in place, hold it, grab your ruler, and it goes pretty quick. So let me show you what we get here. Because it was a tube, when we open it up, we get a square. So this is the fin, and then this will just fade into the rest of the background. So we're going to cut all of our fin units just like this. The last piece we need is a triangle that will fit here and a triangle here. And those are going to be, again, out of the background fabric. Now, if you already had 2.5-inch strips, you will need to sew them together. But if you didn't, just get a 4.5-inch strip. And we're going to use that same template, and we're going to cut some triangles. Now we have all the pieces we need to make our first fish block here. So we're going to sew this one and then this one to that block, and then we will sew that last seam. So we're going to line this up and match the corner. And I like to sew from this corner down towards the point. So I'm going to flip it over and stitch right along here. Now these are all bias edges right now, so you want to be careful you don't stretch. So we will press this seam towards the triangle just gently right now. Put it back in place so we can see where it goes. And now we'll sew this one, again, matching the corner first and sewing towards the point. I am going to take this over to the ironing board, and I'm going to iron it flat, and I'm going to cut off these dog ears, and then all we have to do is stitch down the middle. So there's the first fish. We'll iron it nice and flat, and then we're gonna make 17 more fish. We need 18 fish for this twin size quilt that we're gonna make, and they're looking really happy and colorful. I think this is gonna be a lot of fun. Now that all the fish are pieced together, we're going to lay them out. I'm gonna use my big table here. They're going to be on point. So I'm not gonna lay out the whole quilt, but I'm gonna lay out enough so I can see what's gonna go where. And I'm gonna leave some space between them because there's sashing between them. And I'm gonna trade around till I get a nice layout. So I'm probably not gonna want these two fish right next to each other because they are the exact same fish. So I'm gonna switch it around. And I will just do that till I get all the fish laying out in a really pretty layout. Once I have that done, we've got some sashing that's gonna go between the rows. So I'm gonna have to kind of line these up a little bit here. So the sashing is gonna go between each fish like this. So anytime you're doing something on point, your rows are on the diagonal. It's a little bit tricky when you first get started. But if you start laying out the pieces, you will see those rows come out. Now we can see the fish starting to come to life. So here's the first row, and we've got sashing on both sides of the block. For the rest of the rows, sashing between and on each end. So follow the pattern so you know how many go in each row, but there's always gonna be sashing between and on the ends. So I'm gonna stitch together some of the rows, and then we will show you how to put the rows together with the sashing between the rows as well. I've switched to the floor because it's a pretty big quilt and it's a lot easier for me to lay this out here. You can see the rows. Here is the first row. So it's the fish block with sashing on each side. Then we've got the next row here. It has three fish sashing on the ends and between. So to get these sewn together, we start with this row. We're going to sew this piece on first, then we're going to put these corners on. Then we're going to take this row, sew the sash, the long sashing onto here, and then we're going to sew the rows together, and we're going to keep moving up. So you can see up here on the quilt where I've already got the rows sewn together. And it looks a little more complicated than it is. It really was very, very quick. When you're all done, you've got everything all sewn together, the last thing you're going to do is add these smaller corners in all four corners. Then I'm going to take my straight edge and I'm just going to straighten everything up all the way around. My strip unit had strips left over, so I took all of those and sewed them side by side into a really long strip unit, and then I cut it into 2.5-inch pieces. And I've sewn them together into a really long border here. And I think I'm gonna add this to the quilt for a little pop of color right on the outside. So right now, it's about 2.5 inches. It's a really quick way to get some color around here. So I think I'm gonna add this to the outside. And then I'm going to take more of the deep blue sea and I'm gonna add that. So this is what it will look like if I do about a 2-inch patchwork border. And I actually think that's too much color. So I think I'm gonna cut this down a little. Let me show you what it looks like when it's a little bit smaller. I think it'll look better if I do a very narrow border like that. And I always try things out like this before I sew them onto the quilt because it makes a big difference whether you've got fatter or a narrower. So always feel free to change your mind. So I'm going to finish stitching everything up, get the borders on, and then we will get this onto the quilting machine. I'm so happy with how the quilt turned out. It's such a cheerful fish quilt. And the eyes really made those fish come alive. I just took some little buttons and I just put them on with the zigzag machine. I thought it was gonna take a lot longer, but it really only took a few minutes to get those eyes stitched on. Now, if you're giving a quilt to a very, very young person, you might want to applique some eyes or paint instead of putting buttons on. And if you're gonna use the buttons, I always put a product called fray check on top of the thread so that they won't come undone. So these are nice bright fish, but of course you could do natural colored fish. You could make it much more subdued with a lighter background or an aqua background if you like. I quilted this in a pattern called Calm Waters. You can see the quilting a little better from the back. I use this pattern a lot when we're doing batiks because it really looks like ripply waves. This turned out about 70 by 87, and you can see the little teeny patchwork border that is different than what shows on the pattern, but it was really easy to do with the extra strips. Really, really a fun project. I just want to thank everybody for watching and let you know I really, really appreciate all the comments that you leave. I read everyone personally. I can't always have the time to answer all of them, but I really appreciate all of our viewers. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Matt Jordan from Jordan Fabrics here in Grants Pass, Oregon. And we're going to be giving away this beautiful throw size log cabin quilt. The prints are called Safari and they are from RJR Fabrics. I loved working with this group. It has a very bright look, almost a batik look to me, but a little brighter. Beautiful quilting as you can see. This is a lovely throw style quilt. Nice backing. It's a really soft little leaf pattern there.
It's real easy to enter the contest. All you have to do is click on the link in the description below, enter your email address and your name. And this contest is open to everyone and we can ship worldwide. Good luck.